Hey, it's Andy from SmartWP, and today I'm going to show you how to add code snippets to your WordPress site. Now, if you've been trying to customize your WordPress site, you may have noticed a lot of sites will offer PHP code snippets to customize it. Now, if you're unfamiliar with doing that or editing your functions.php file, you're in the right place. There's a couple methods to do it. One involves using a plugin, which is probably more beginner friendly, and we're going to do that first. And secondly, I'm actually going to show you how to edit a functions.php file using a child theme, which is a more advanced way, but probably the recommended way. But first, let's hop into the easier method, and that's using a plugin called Code Snippets. So I'm already logged into my WordPress site here. We'll go into the dashboard, and I'm going to add a new plugin. We'll go to Plugins, Add New. And then the plugin that we're going to add is called Code Snippets. And you can see it up here with 300,000 active installs. It has this little logo here. Make sure you get the right one. This is the one we'll be using. And I'll install it and I'll activate it. So now that it's added, you'll see a new option on the left side here for code snippets. So we'll go there. There's a few example code snippets, for example, adding CSS and HTML and things like that. So if you're watching this video, you probably already have a code snippet that you want to add, but just in case you don't, on smartwp.com, we actually have a list of a bunch of different code snippets that you can add. Just for example, the first one up here disables the admin bar while you're viewing the site. So I'm actually going to use that one in our example here, but there's definitely plenty other things you can add. If you ever see anybody say, add this code snippet to your functions.php file, it should work using this method. But just for this example, we'll be using this small snippet that hides the admin bar while you're logged in. So let's go back to our site here. We're going to do add new snippet, and we're going to call this snippet hide admin bar. And we're just going to paste our snippet in. You can see I have a comment here. Of course, you can put a comment at the bottom as well in the description here, so you can look later. The code snippets plugin also lets you choose where you want it to run on your site. We're going to run this snippet everywhere, which is where most snippets are probably going to be run. So we'll hit save changes and we'll hit activate. Now let's go to the front end of our site. And you can see now we don't have an admin bar, so that means that the code snippet worked. So let's go back to our code snippet, and I just want to make one important note about using this plugin. If you have a code snippet that's actually broken, so for example, I'm going to break the code snippet here by adding a backspace there, it'll actually warn you that the syntax is wrong, but let's save our changes anyway. And you can see we have a huge error pop up here, but luckily the plugin does catch this. So if we just reload the page here, you'll see that it actually didn't save our change here. So that's a really important thing to note. Make sure your code is valid before just pasting it in and activating it. So I'm actually gonna deactivate this code snippet now, and we're gonna actually go to the homepage, and you can see the admin bar is still there now. So that's how you turn the code snippets off and on. Really simple and really easy. Now we're actually gonna hop into the more advanced method and probably the more preferable method, especially if you're more familiar with editing code in a code editor and using FTP. So I'm actually gonna close my browser here, and I'm gonna use an FTP client. If you don't know how to log into your FTP, you can reach out to your web host and they'll give you information about logging into your server. So right now I'm in the root of our WordPress site, and I'll go to WP content and I'll go to themes, and you can see we're actually using GeneratePress for our theme here. So let me go in here, and there's actually a functions.php file here. Now your inclination will be to edit this one, but if GeneratePress has an update come out, it will actually overwrite all of your changes. So you're gonna wanna get a child theme to actually keep your changes in the site without actually having updates break it. So let me show you how to get a child theme. Now, one thing you can do is use this plugin called Child Theme Generator, and it'll actually take the information in your WordPress theme and make a child theme for you. Additionally, you can use this site here called WordPress Child Theme Creator, and it'll allow you to put in all the information about your theme and it'll create a child theme. But most likely, if you're using a more supported theme, for example, since I'm using GeneratePress, I can just Google GeneratePress child theme. And you can see here they have documentation about child themes, so we'll go to that. And the first thing you'll see here is they have a download to a child theme, so I'm just gonna download that child theme. And then I'm gonna upload the child theme to our site here. So now you can see we have GeneratePress and GeneratePress Child. And you can see the child theme is a really bare bones version. Basically, a child theme adds on changes on top of a theme. So it's a lot safer to make changes this way, because then the core theme getting updated won't actually break the changes you make. And you can see here the GeneratePress child theme offers a functions.php, a screenshot, and a style CSS file. And of course, we're going to be focusing on the functions.php file. So let's open it up in our code editor here. So we're gonna go in here and actually paste our code snippet that we had previously, the one we just used in the plugin. The same thing, show admin bar, return false. We'll save that. and make sure it's uploaded to the server, you can see that the file has changed. So let's go back to our site here and hit refresh. You can still see we see the admin bar here, but that's because we haven't activated our child theme. So let me go to the admin here and we'll go to appearance, themes. And you can see now we have generate press and generate press child. Let's activate the child and we'll go back to our homepage. And now you can see the theme is the same, but the top bar is actually gone now because our functions.php file is running that code snippet. You should have no issue activating a child theme, but I have noticed, for example, sometimes additional CSS won't actually carry over because it thinks it's a new theme. So just make sure that your additional CSS and things like that have carried over. But otherwise, you're free to edit everything in your new functions.php file. And of course, if you need more code snippet ideas, I have an article on smartwp.com that I'll include in the description with more code snippet ideas. And I hope this video was helpful. Remember to like and subscribe. And if you have any questions or concerns, just let me know in the comments below. And thanks again for watching. See ya.